Jesus says, those who love their life lose it, and those who hate their life in this world will keep it for eternal life. We've seen a lot of death this past year, and we continue to see more. We've also had to change our patterns of living as a result. We've often seen frustration with that change, and the refusal to change, the holding on of the old patterns. With that, we've seen that it leads only to more death. Now, just as Jesus tells us in John, if we hold on to what we want, and what we want and nothing else, we will ultimately lose our life. That life isn't our life here in this world, but that's the life that we have to come eternally in being with Jesus. However, if we can put aside the desires we have, to live our life the way that we want, not the way that God wants, if we can put that desire aside, we can put that desire aside for Jesus' sake, then we will have that eternal life with Christ Jesus. Now, it's no coincidence that Jesus follows this statement about life by speaking about those who follow him. Because if we follow Jesus, we're no longer living our lives for ourselves. Instead, our lives become about God, about Jesus Christ. And yes, doing so means giving up those things that we desire. But it means that in doing so, we gain the deep and abiding connection that we have with God, our Creator, the very giver of our life and our being. When we look around at this past year and everything that's happened in every single facet of our lives, we can see that there are dire consequences, not only for failing to follow Jesus as we look to that future life, that eternal life with our Lord and Maker, but there's also a steep price to pay for not following Jesus in this life now. So if we want to move forward, if we want to learn, if we want to continue to come closer to Jesus, we will all have to sacrifice our own wants and desires and learn to adjust to new patterns of living. Certainly we don't want this pandemic, the COVID-19 pandemic, to become like the Spanish flu pandemic 100 years ago, something that generations past us will look at and say, whoops, should have learned something there. But we also don't want to create an irreparable, an inseparable wedge between ourselves and God. So listen to Jesus' words. Put aside your own wants and desires for your own lives. Instead, embrace service to our Lord Jesus Christ, even if it takes you into patterns of living that you may not want to fall into. serve Jesus and serve Jesus alone, even if it appears on the surface to be more than a little.